A very good morning, dear students. So let us start today's class of computer science second year syllabus chapter 7, classes and objects. Okay, so in the previous class I discussed on member functions. So the member functions can be actually of, it can be defined in two ways, that is inside member functions and outside class definition. Okay, so in today's class how the member functions can be accessed we'll see. So the members of the class can be of data and function, is it right? So the member functions, it can be a data or it can be a function. Okay, so you all know there are three kinds of access specifiers, one is private, other one is protected, and other one is public. Okay, so these three kinds of access specifiers which is associated with the members of the class can be accessed for the class, how means for public, for protected and private members of the class can be accessed only through the member functions of the class. Okay, so there is no other way to access the member functions of the class, which is private and protected, is it right? So then the public data members, how it is accessed means with the dot operator. So how the objects are accessed with a public data member is with a just a dot operator. Okay, so in one more point you should know, no function outside a class can include statements to access directly. Okay, so always there should be a function inside the class. It should not be outside of the function. Okay students, so we'll see how it can be accessed through a syntax. See, members of the class can be accessed with the object name dot data member. Okay, so the member functions, how it can be accessed is object name dot member functions, within that there is a arguments list. Okay, so this is how it can be accessed. See, class, so for example computer science I'll give as a class name, inside that data member will be there followed by semicolon and member functions will be there, is it right? So this is a general form of class. So how it can be accessed, so the data member can be accessed by representing a object name dot data member. Okay, and how the member functions can be accessed is by representing the object name dot member functions, and what are the arguments you have to pass to the function, that has to be passed here. Okay, I hope you all understood, dear students. So now we'll move on to how the arrays of the members can be accessed. Okay, so the arrays can be used as a data member of the classes. Okay, so this can be a private or a public member of the class. So even array is what? It is a homogeneous element. So here I'm giving array name as A and its memory location I'm giving 10. Okay, so this array elements can also be acting as a data member and it can be passed even for the function. Okay, so next, array of objects. So array of objects, an array having a class type elements is known as array of objects. So if there is a objects, it can be passed individually. If there is an array of objects, so then it has to be passed with the braces. Okay, so this is the array of objects which can be passed. Like how it is declared and defined after the class definition is same as the as usual how we define an array. Okay, so this we will explain through an example. See here, class name is what? Employee. Employee is a class name, and these are all what? Data member. Character name and int age is a data member which is for a employee data. Okay, so then it can have array of objects. So objects here is array of object here is supervisor, sales executive and team lead. Okay, so this further can be accessed through an object. Means for employee, I'll just show employee is a object dot even. So after creating this even, I'll be using that. This is how it can be accessed further. As of now, you all should know this is a passing of array of objects to the function. Okay, so next we'll see objects as functional arguments. So how it can be acting for a arguments through functions. So until in the last example you saw data member, is it right? So here you are passing data member, that is a variable you are passing, but now we have to even pass the function. Okay, so a function can receive a object as a function argument. So this is how similar to be the data being sent to the function arguments. Just we are sending a data. For example, I'll write a apple function here. So apple function can have, wait, I'll write a apple function here. So this apple function can pass a variable called as a. So this is what, this is a argument which is passed for apple function. Okay, so this object can be passed in two ways. So one is copy of entire object is passed to the function. So this is called as pass by value. So this is a very important question which will be asked in every interviews, and even it will be asked for examination point of view. You should know what do you mean by pass by value and pass by reference. Okay, so pass by value in the sense here you are passing the copy of object. So copy of object, entire copy will be passed to the function. But whereas other way is there, only their address is sent. So that is pass by reference. Okay students, so next we'll move on to how this pass by value is done, and in further how the pass by reference is done, we'll see. So pass by value, so here the function creates a copy of the object, so that has to be passed to the function. Okay, see here, the copy of the object is passed to the function. Therefore, changes made to the objects inside the function do not affect the original object which is outside. Okay students, so the pass by value in the sense here you are creating a copy of the object and it is passed to the function. So here it is passed, here the function is there and here it is passed. Okay, so if you pass the object, original object will not change. Okay, so then how the pass by reference is done? Okay, see, when an address of the object is passed to the function directly works on the original object used in the function call. Okay, so when there is an address, not a copy of the object, when there is an address of an object is passed to the function directly works on the original object. Okay, so it is there in the function call. Okay, so here also there is no changes made to the object inside the function which will reflect to the original object. Before also the same thing, the original object will as usual, it will be a same thing, but the real object which is we are acting, so that will not be a changed. Okay, this pass by reference is more efficient since it requires only the passing of address of object, not the entire object. Understood students? So here the pass by reference will indicates only the address of the object but not the entire object. Okay, so this is the thing, you can actually pass the object to the function using two ways. Okay, so one is passed by value, another one is passed by reference. When an entire copy of the object is passed to the function, it is called as passed by value. When the only address of the object is passed to the function, it is called as a passed by reference. Okay. So then you should know the differences between the structures and the unions. Okay. Structure is always defined with a keyword called as struct, but union is defined with a keyword called as a class. Okay. All the members of the structures are public by default, but all the members of the classes are private by default. Okay. So in structures it will be a public, whereas in unions it will be a private. Okay. The structures cannot be inherited, but union can be inherited because it is started with a class. It is mentioned, predefined with a class variable, class keyword actually. Okay. Then what are the other differences? The structures contains only a data members, but union is a class, is it right? So it will contain both data member and member function. There is no data hiding in structures, but there can be a data hiding in unions since it is mentioned with a class. Okay. See, I'll again repeat. A structure is a keyword, is defined with a keyword struct, but a class is defined with a keyword class. So all the members of the structures are public, whereas this data members, this union members are, it will be a private by default. It cannot be inherited, structures cannot be inherited, but unions, that is classes, can be inherited. Structures contains only data members. A class contains both data members and member functions. Here in structures there is no data hiding. In unions there is having a data hiding features by using access specifiers. So this is the difference you should know between structures and unions. Dear students, I think you all understood. So next you should remember the points from this chapter, which is very very important from exam point of view and also for your knowledge perspective. See here, a class is a user defined data that combines or that contains both data members and objects. Okay. So object means what? It is an instance of a class, or it is a basic building block of a class. Okay. So then the scope of resolution operator. So in the previous class I discussed, outside of the member function has to be accessed, means you have to use this scope of resolution operator. Then what else comes in this class is access specifiers. Public, protected and private access specifiers are there in order to access the member functions. So these are the key points you should know in order to score maximum number of marks from this chapter. Okay students, if you are having any doubts, you can contact me. Thank you.